In this video, we
can't believe it.
What?
You've became what you hate.
I've become what I hate? An Omega Seamaster Professional 300. That makes no sense.
No, a dirty Tudorian.
Dirty Tudorian? Good God, woman.
You should have bought the Submariner.
This is way better than a Submariner. This watch has a soul, and people like this don't buy this watch. This is better, I promise you. Now let's find out why. In this video, we're gonna check out why the Black Bay 58 is superior to the legendary Rolex Submariner. Five reasons. Number one, brand. The Rolex brand name is one of the most powerful luxury brand names in the world. It is a double-edged sword, however, it is not all positive. Before the yuppie era, it was known as a tough tool watch for professionals. Have you ever seen a Submariner on someone's wrist and told them, hey, nice sub? And they said, no, it's not a sub, it's a Rolex. That's when you know you've crossed the line. It has become more of a status symbol, a message to society that I have made it. Definitely leaning towards more of a fashion brand now. I know a ton of people that own Rolexes that don't like watches, don't know anything about watches, don't set the time, but the Rolex is always on the wrist, and that doesn't sit right with watch enthusiasts, or at least me. Chime in down below. What do you guys think? I love the brand. I love their world firsts, their contributions to horology, but their fame has become a negative, in my opinion. It's just something I don't like to be associated with. And I know, yes, that's kind of a hipster mindset, but it's just not a good situation for this brand right now, I feel. So the brand name Rolex, yes, the most powerful in the world, but I'm gonna say it's a negative, and that's why the Tudor Black Bay 58 is better in that regard. Okay, reason number two is much more obvious. It is just the size. The Black Bay 58 is 39 millimeters, widely regarded as the best watch size in the world. The Rolex Submariner has grown 41 millimeters. I measured it at 40.8, but nonetheless, growing larger. Maybe the next gen is gonna be 42. 43, who knows? It lost its elegance, its grace from the beautiful five-digit sub. That is my opinion. Now, they did slim down those crown guards just a tad. They're still bulbous and look like plumped up lips. And they did slim down those lugs, but they're still reminiscent of the super case. Still see that big profile. And maybe it's on purpose for presence, but definitely with the Black Bay 58, you get a more streamlined, sleek looking case, something you want to wear on the wrist, something that just disappears and screams class. So reason number two why the Black Bay 58 is better than the Rolex Submariner is its size. Let me know down below, am I off my rocker? Reason number three, the Black Bay 58 comes with an aluminum insert. And I know most of you are gonna say, hey, wait a minute, that's a negative. That's cheap. That's a cheap metal. This insert has warmth to it. You just can't compete with aluminum. And it's gonna patina to a beautiful light gray, get all scratched up, and it's gonna be absolutely beautiful. So when we look at the Rolex insert, we can see it's cold, dead look. There's absolutely no warmth to it. It's very shiny. It's gonna be shiny forever. It's never gonna scratch. And there's something dead about that. Every Homage, Clone, Steel Dive, those cheap, fake China watches that copy Seikos and copy Rolex, they all have ceramic insert. And I know everyone loves ceramic inserts, but they look a little cheap to me, definitely, especially because all the cheap watches have it now for $99. And they definitely give me an empty feeling, but it makes sense. This watch is no longer a tool watch. It's jewelry. It's supposed to be shiny forever. It's just supposed to be on your wrist and not really tell you the time. It's just supposed to look pretty. And now number four, the handset. The handset is iconic, the Mercedes handset. However, they look a little bit dainty, a little bit thin, and a little bit feminine for such a big, bulky, structured case like this. They're nicely curved, and of course they're beautiful white gold, but they're just a little fragile for the look of those big bold indices. They kind of don't match the tool vibe of this watch. When we look at the Black Bay 58, we got bold, thick, strong snowflake hands. Really matches the tool watch vibe, which I'm a huge fan of. Just makes this watch look tougher. Look at that snowflake hour hand. I know a lot of people don't like them, but I'm a huge fan. I think being flat really helps it out. The Rolex hands are gently curved, making them look even more thin and slim. These are completely flat and bold design. So big fan of the hands as well. More masculine in the design. And last but not least is the comfort. This thing is absolutely unbelievably comfortable. I cannot believe how comfortable it is. Now, when you look at the case back, you can see it's ultra thin. Now, when we check out the iconic Rolex Submariner and we see the case back, you can see how much it sticks out. It has a flat case. That case back is so deep because this has 300 meters of water resistance. And that just digs into your wrist for no reason. This is a piece of jewelry. Make it thin like the GMT. The GMT is so comfortable. And when I put it on my wrist, you can definitely see the watch is floating. You see that gap? That's that huge case back. I wore this watch when I first reviewed it months ago for 24 hours. I wore it for one day and it was bugging my arm. It was so annoying to wear, but I just kept wearing it because, you know, I wanted to see the hype on the new 41s, and definitely do not get it with this huge case back. If you have a little bit of a bigger wrist, maybe not as bony, it's not going to be uncomfortable for you. But for me, ultra uncomfortable, and I don't like when the watch floats. Now let's check out the Black Bay 58 on the wrist. As you can see, the case is still flat, just like the Rolex's. Just a slight downturn, but there is less float, almost nothing. See that? I'm gonna try to exaggerate it. So definitely a lot better fitting, just because the case back does not dig into the wrist. So way more comfortable. I'm a big fan of it. And I think the Submariner should definitely address that issue. Okay, guys, I think that was the five. Did I hit five? Yeah. Just in case, let's do a bonus six. Okay. This has a beautiful boxed sapphire, which just screams class. And it's something interesting to look at. This has a boring, flat sapphire. All right, so there, that's the sixth reason. All right, guys, I can do another video, five reasons why the Submariner is better than the Black Bay 58. Let me know down in the comments if you want that. That video is actually easy to make compared to this one. This one, it's harder to find the reasons because the Sub is so iconic. And Sub fans, you know what? Try not to get too upset. I know you love your Subs, and that's fine. Stick to them. Enjoy the waitlist, bros. Also, another bonus, stainless steel, more scratch resistant, harder on the Rockwell scale. So it's technically a harder substance than 904 stainless steel. 316L is 95, this 70 to 90, depending on the grade. So more scratch resistant as well. But the 904 is more corrosion resistant, so it's better for marine life. But then again, who's really diving with these pieces of jewelry? I know some people must be, but you know what I mean. You get my point. All right, guys, if you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.